what is it about Spandau Ballet that makes them so timeless and slightly magical?
Oh, wow. That's a really good question. I mean, they have such an amazing selection of songs. I mean, I can't wait to hear all the old songs tonight. I remember when I was just 20, maybe 19, and I heard, to cut a long story short, back in the New Romantic days, down at a local club in Hertfordshire, and they were all in their kilts, and I just thought, oh, they're so cool and sexy, and they're still cool and sexy, and I'm really pleased to know them now as mates, and so that's why I'm here, really, to, as a mate, to give them support.
I know you and Tony obviously got high together in a very literal sense with your concert in the sky. Can you tell us a little bit about that record-breaking performance?
Yeah, we're record breakers. We did the highest gig in the sky. Tony got up and did some songs beautifully, and I got up and did some songs, and then we share that accolade. So, and we had a real laugh doing it. I mean, he's such great fun, Tony, and all the band are, and I consider him a real mate.
Of course, you've got your own new album coming out next year. Can you tell us a little bit about what we can expect?
Well, it's very 80s influence, actually, but a lot of music these days is. And it'd be, you know, power pop tunes and me kind of pouting a lot and staring meaningfully into the camera and singing strong melodies and pop tunes. We still love pop tunes, don't we?
Oh, no, definitely. I mean, but the pop industry has changed a bit. I mean, what do you make of current pop icons, people like Miley Cyrus and that? How do you think they compare to the icons of the 80s?
Do you know what? If I'm very honest with you, I don't pay too much attention to pop icons now. I really don't. I just kind of keep my head down and get on with what I'm doing, if I'm really honest with you. The last album that I listened to was probably The Foo Fighters. When I started, I was really inspired by all kinds of people, from Joni Mitchell to Debbie Harry. And I think most female artists would mention those two female artists. I don't think many wouldn't mention them.
What's the best advice you've been given in the business?
I think probably from my dad, and he always said never compromise. And so, you know, I've said it to my son. My son's got a new band called Blighty Inc., and he's only 16, and he's sort of got he was getting his sort of arm bent to do something that he didn't want to do. And I said, son, don't start compromising now. If you do it now, you'll do it for the rest of your life. So, yeah, never compromise. Never compromise. Well, I mean, I hope he discovers gardening or something else. I mean, you know, when I got out the music business and discovered something else, that life could be something else other than being Kim Wilde, it was really fantastic. It was the best part of my life. I met my husband, had our kids, and my life totally transformed. So I imagine his will too. He's been to take that for a long, long time, and he needs to find out who else Jason Orange can be. And it'll be an amazing thing. When you shut one door, it's so true, another will open, but you have to shut it firmly, otherwise the other one won't open quite so wide. So as long as he's really shut the door, then he can expect some fantastic gifts, I think. I think he'll have an amazing life. He's a lovely man. I kind of came because my mate, who's mates with Spandau, sort of said, you know, she got me a ticket, and I thought, oh yeah, I can't miss that. So I kind of wasn't planning to do all this rambling. So I think I'm going to go and grab a glass of champagne and watch Spandau Ballet.